Good morning, students. So continuing forward, we started yesterday with a new chapter of Maths 2. That was lesson number 1, Commission, Brokerage and Discount. So continuing with the same exercise, before that, a quick brush up of the formulas which we studied yesterday. Commission is always calculated on sales. If sales is not given in the question, assume sales to be X. If you find out the words such as exceed, over 10,000, over the total sales, then at that time you have to utilize the formula amount is equal to total sales minus exceeding amount. That is over wala. Over wala means the exceeding. For example, if it is 10,000 or 50,000, and we had done sums related to this yesterday. Commission is equal to total sales into R upon 100. And Del Creditor Commission is equal to total sales into R upon 100. Del Creditor, as I told you, he is the person who takes the guarantee that whatever the price the seller is quoting for the product, the buyer or the party brought by the agent will pay it, or else he will pay it on behalf of the buyer. So for that, he gets an additional or extra commission, which is called as Del Creditor Commission. Now today class, our focus will be sums related to this particular formula. Can you all see? Income is equal to salary plus commission on sales. So we'll be utilizing this formula and calculating the sums. So pay attention, students. We'll be starting with the sums shortly. All right? Okay. So coming to question number 8, yesterday we finished 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th and 6th. Now today we'll be completing the remaining sums related to commissions topic. So first, starting with sum number 8. Deepak's salary was increased from 4,000 to 5,000. The sales being the same, due to reduction in the rate of commission from 3% to 2%, his income remained unchanged. Find his sales. So as I told you, students, commission ka sum hai, saath hi saath salary ki baat ho rahi hai, commission bhi aaya hai, and they are talking about finding the sales. You have to find the sales. What were the sales made by Deepak? So as you all can see, the word salary, commission. So we'll be using the formula income is equal to salary plus commission on sales. But the first thing, as I told you, as sales are not given, your sum will start with the dialogue. Let the total sales be X. So here's the solution. Pay attention. Let the total sales be X. Income is equal to salary plus commission on sales. Always remember, students, whenever you are utilizing the formula, just put it in a bracket. Highlight the formula so that at least the person who is checking your paper knows that at least you know the formula, you know the concept, which formula is applied in the particular sum. So as I told you, we are using the formula. As per the condition, income we don't know. 4,000 plus X into 3 upon 100. Now where did this X into 3 upon 100 come from? Remember the formula, commission ka formula kya hai? Total sales into R upon 100. So always remember, commission ke liye you have to use that formula. Commission on sales is equal to total sales into R upon 100. So using this formula, what were the total sales? Tell me. They were X and the rate of commission was 3%. So 3 upon 100. I hope that is clear. So income is equal to 4000 plus 3X upon 100, point number 1. Now, as you all saw in the question, the rate of commission reduced from 3% to 2%. And the salary of Deepak increased from 4,000 to 5,000. So, as per the condition, income is equal to 5,000 plus X into 2 upon 100. So, 5,000 plus 2X upon 100, point number 2. Now, if you remember, yesterday we did such kind of sum where this dialogue was repeated. And today, again, the same dialogue is repeated. So, what's the dialogue? इनकम रिमेन्स अनचेंज्ड, भले सैलरी बढ़ गई 4,000 से 5,000, भले रेट ऑफ कमीशन गिर गया 3% से 2%, लेकिन बंदे के इनकम में कोई भी चेंज नहीं आया है. सो दैट इज व्हाई पॉइंट नंबर 1 इज इक्वल टू पॉइंट नंबर 2. सो 4000 प्लस 3x अपॉन 100 इज इक्वल टू 5000 प्लस 2x अपॉन 100. सो देन ब्रिंगिंग द लाइक टर्म्स टुगेदर, एज यू ऑल कैन सी, आई बॉट 3x अपॉन 100 माइनस 2x एंड 5000 माइनस 4000. So x upon 100 is equal to 1000. So there's a printing mistake. Just be careful. So by mistake, I have written 10,000. It's only 1000 over there. So x upon 100 is equal to 1000. So x is equal to 1 lakh. So total sales made by Deepak is nothing but 1 lakh rupees. Easy? Clear? How to do the sums? So, this was the first sum by utilizing the same formula. Okay. Moving forward with the next sum, pay attention. Just give me a second. All right. Coming to sum number 5. Here's the question. Giving you all 2 minutes to read the question. Priya gets salary of 15,000 per month and commission at 8% on the sales over 50,000. If she is getting 17,400 in a certain month, find the sales made by her in that month. So again, students, I'll ask you all, what were the punch words which you all saw in the question? Again, they are telling you to find the sales. So our sum will begin from the dialogue. Let the total sales made by Priya be X. Now, Priya is getting a salary of 15,000 per month. So, this is salary wala formula. Also, you have commission word given. That is commission on sales. And one more thing. If she gets 17,400, gets means income hai, usko mil raha hai. So, can you all see the three combination? Income is equal to salary plus commission on sales. Another thing, if you noticed, was commission usko tabhi mil raha hai jab sales are over 50,000. So remember this word, over wala formula bhi aane wala hai yahan pe. So she is not getting commission on the total sales, but she will get the commission only if she makes sales over 50,000. So there are 4 things we'll be doing. Number 1, let the sales be X. Number 2, you will find out exceeding amount wala formula you will put and find out the amount. Number 3, you'll use the formula income is equal to salary plus commission on sales. Okay, so now pay attention how to go step by step. So let the total sales made by her be X. Her monthly salary was 15,000, which was given. Sales amount over 50,000. So what was the formula? Amount is equal to total sales minus over wala amount. So don't write over wala, write exceeding amount. So the total sales as we saw is X and the exceeding amount over ke baad kaun sa amount hai? 50,000. So X minus 50,000. Now since alphabet and numbers cannot be subtracted, we'll put the brackets. Please remember this thing. So commission amount is equal to total sales into R upon 100. So X minus 50,000 into 8 upon 100. So 8X upon 100 minus 4 lakh upon 100. It will be multiplied by both. So next step moving forward, the income received. She gets 17,400, which is given in the question. So income is equal to salary plus commission on sales. So income ke niche aayega 17,400 given in the question. Salary mein aayega 15,000 again given in the question. Plus commission on sales. Yahan pe aapne dhoonda na upar. 8x upon 100 minus 4 lakh upon 100. Now bringing like terms together. 15 ko the transfer karke minus kar diya. Again there's a writing mistake over here. So after subtraction, you don't get 12,400. You get only 2,400. So that is why, students, I tell you all, you do your calculations. Don't depend on the sums which I am sending you all. It's just for your reference purpose. If you practice, you will understand how to do the sums, and there's no need to by heart also, if the concept is clear. So the denominator was 100 common. I sent it that side, so into 100. So you got 2,40,000 plus 4 lakh is equal to 8x. Okay, so that gives you 6,40,000. All right, not 1 lakh, the not 16,40,000. You get only 1 lakh, 6,40,000. Again, the printing mistake is there, so ignore that one. So this amount is also wrong. So 6,40,000 is equal to 8x. 6,40,000 divided by 8. 8 8s are 64. So answer is 80,000, not 2,05,000. This is your final answer. Understood? So this is your next sum. I hope it is clear. Again, the formula which we used was income is equal to salary plus commission on sales. Okay. All right. Coming to the next one. Just give me a second. Okay. So, you all can read the next question which is given over here. The next one we are targeting is, I guess, sum numbers 7 and 10 are remaining. So, we can target those sums. So, you all pay attention and read it. Give me 2 minutes. I'm just coming. Just open up the sums for you all. Okay, so have you all read the sum? Read it carefully, properly, because it's a little big question, but easy one. The sum is easy. You read it properly. So we are targeting first sum number 10, right? So, how many cars are given in the question? There are 3 cars, correct? Commission on all the 3 cars is given to you all. First car, second car, third car, it is given. You have to find. So, sorry, I didn't share the question. Sorry for the thing. All right. So, now giving you all 2 minutes, just read the question. There were 3 cars which were sold through an agent for 2,40,000, 2,22,000 and 2,25,000. So there are 3 cars. The sales amount are given in front of you. The rate of commission are 17.5% on the first car, 12.5% on the second car. If the agent charges overall 14% commission on total sales, find the rate of commission paid on the third car. Okay, so sum is very easy. Pay attention. So we start the sum like this. The total sales of first car was 2,40,000. Commission amount on the first car 17.5, which is also given. So we'll put the formula. Commission is equal to total sales into R upon 100. So 2,40,000 into 17.5 upon 100. I have always told you all, remove the decimal first. So in the next line, 175 upon 1000. 30 cut. Multiply karke you get 42,000. That is on the first car. The same thing you'll repeat for the second car also. Total sales of second car 2,22,000. Commission amount on the second car 12.5%. So commission is equal to total sales into R upon 100. So 2,22,000 into 12.5 upon 100. I've removed the decimal, so I got the second car commission as well. total sales of the third car 2,25,000, which was given, but the commission on the third car is not given. You have to find the rate of commission on the third car. So we'll assume let the commission amount on the third car be X percent. Okay. So commission is equal to 2,25,000 into X upon 100, which gives you 2,250X. Now one more thing was given, total commission 14% on total sales. So you all didn't have total sales. So first we'll find the total sales of all the three cars together, which gives me 2,40,000 plus 2,22,000 plus 2,25,000, which gives me 6,87,000. On the total sales, the agent is charging how much percent commission? 14% commission. So again, I'll put commission ka formula. Commission is equal to total sales into R upon 100. 6,87,000 into 14 upon 100 gives me 96,180. So now we can write the formula. Total commission received is equal to commission on the first car plus commission on the second car plus commission on the third car. So I've written the values over here. 96,180, 42 plus 27,750 plus 2,250X. Now, as you all know, you cannot add the numbers and alphabet together. So keep this aside. And as you can see, I've underlined the first two numbers. Inquired karke aapko milega 69,750. Then you'll subtract 69,750 that side. Udhar chala jayega. Then you get 26,430, which is equal to 2,250X. X is equal to 11.74%. Is the sum clear? Got it? Okay. So sum is big, but it is easy. Okay. Coming to sum number 9. An agent is paid a commission of 7% on cash sales and 5% on credit sales made by him. If on the sale of 1,02,000, the agent claims a total commission of 6,420, find the cash sales and the credit sales. Okay, so sum is little different, but again very easy. Now total sales is equal to cash sales plus credit sales. Abhi aapke paas ye bar sum mein cash sales or credit sales nahi hai, lekin you have total sales. ये जो 1,02,000 दिख रहा है, that is called as the total sales. लेकिन they have told you to find cash sales कितना है उसमें से और credit sales कितना है. I hope you know what is a credit sale. That is, you are buying the goods right now, but you are making the payment later on. So again, we continue the sum like this. Here's the solution. Pay attention. So let the cash sales be denoted by X and credit sales be denoted by Y. So total sales is equal to cash sales plus credit sales. So total sales hai 1,02,000, cash sales is X and credit sales is Y. Now pay attention to the next step which I have done. Y is equal to 1,02,000 minus X. Now what is the reason of doing this way? In the entire sum, I do not require two variables. If I take two variables, it would not be possible for me to solve the sum. So that is why in order to get a common variable, what I did is keeping Y this side, I transferred X that side so that I get a common variable in both, which makes it easier for the sum to be solved properly and get the final answer. So this is one of the most important stages. You have to pay attention to this stage very, very carefully. So I'm marking this so that you remember that cash credit wale sum mein apni ye step karna hi hai, compulsory. Okay. So cash sales was X and credit sales Y, jo ki abhi ban gaya 1,02,000 minus X. Okay. So now you have both cash sales and credit sales. So now we can remove the commission on both. So sabse pehle commission on cash sales. What is the formula? Total sales into R upon 100. So total sales was cash sales was X into 7 upon 100, 7X upon 100. Point number one. Commission on credit sales Y into 5 upon 100. लेकिन y के बदले व्हाट वी आर यूजिंग 1,02,000 माइनस x इनटू 5/100. अगेन देयर इज अ ब्रैकेट सो दैट विल बी मल्टीप्लाइड बाय बोथ 5,10,000 माइनस 5x अपॉन 100 पॉइंट नंबर 2. Now the total commission charged by the agent is 6,420, which is already given in the question. So the formula becomes total commission received is equal to commission on cash sales plus commission on credit sales. So 6,420 is equal to 7x upon 100 plus 5,10,000 minus 5x upon 100. Since the denominator is same, we'll write one common number 100. 7x minus 5x gives you 2x. You subtract 5,10,000 and send 100 that side, cross multiply. So you get 1,32,000 after subtraction, which gives you 66,000. Now that was only cash sales. So out of 1,02,000, 66,000 ka apne cash sales kiye. So what will be the remaining credit sales? Credit sales denoted as Y. Y is equal to 1,02,000 minus X, which gives you 1,02,000 minus 66,000, which gives you 36,000. Okay? Clear? All right. So coming towards the last sum for the day, that is sum number 7. So with this, we'll be finishing off the commission part, commission and brokerage part. So in tomorrow's video, we will be focusing on a new topic, but the same exercise. That will be discount. So that will continue tomorrow. So before we wind off, let's just quickly see sum number 7 and then we'll wind off the session for today. Mr. Pawan is paid a fixed weekly salary plus commission based on the percentage of sales made by him. If on the sale of 68,000 and 73,000 in two successive weeks, he received 9,880 and 10,180, find the weekly salary and rate of commission paid by him. Now, some important things to pay attention in this sum is, I'm telling you all, just listen to it very carefully. Okay. Now, some of the punch words you see over here are not commission, not salary, not anything else, but only one word. Can you see this word? Successive. तो जैसे ही आपके क्वेश्चन में ये वर्ड आपको नजर आएगा यू हैव टू फॉलो अ फिक्स्ड पैटर्न. सम का पैटर्न फिक्स्ड है. भले ये वर्ड आपको दिख जाए, क्वेश्चन सेम आएगा, ओनली द फिगर्स विल बी चेंज्ड, बट द पैटर्न विल रिमेन द सेम. सो व्हाट डिड आई से, आपको सक्सेसिव वर्ड दिखेगा तो आपने ये वाली ट्रिक फॉलो करनी है जो मैं समझा रही हूँ. Now let's see what's the trick. Pay attention. Coming to sum number 7. All right. So can you see in the solution I've written successive word aaya, so you have to follow this pattern. So first step is you have to find the salary and commission. So I'll assume let the weekly salary be X. सो सैलरी वर्ड आया तो समझ जाना कौन सा फॉर्मूला यूज करना है. इनकम इज इक्वल टू सैलरी प्लस कमीशन ऑन सेल्स. नाउ हाउ विल यू कम टू नो व्हाट इज द इनकम? कैन यू सी द वर्ड रिसीव्ड ओवर हियर? रिसीव्ड 9,000 एंड 10,000. तो रिसीव का मतलब होता है इनकम. सो इनकम के नीचे 9,880 एंड 10,180 साइमल्टेनियसली आई एम राइटिंग. ओके, सैलरी एक्स लिया है तो एक्स एंड एक्स प्लस प्लस कमीशन ऑन टोटल सेल्स इज ऑलरेडी गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन एज यू विल सी 68,000 एंड 73,000. पॉइंट नंबर 1, पॉइंट नंबर 2. तो पैटर्न क्या है? यू आर सॉल्विंग बोथ द इक्वेशन साइमल्टेनियसली. सो आफ्टर सब्ट्रैक्शन एक्स एंड एक्स गेट्स कैंसिल. 10,000 minus 9,000, sign of the greater number, so you get minus 300. Again, minus 73,000, may say 68,000, you'll minus, so you'll get minus commission on 5,000. Minus, minus, dono jagah se cancel ho gaya. Now, what is remaining is 300 is equal to commission on 5,000. Commission is nothing but total sales into R upon 100. तो जहां पे कमीशन दिख रहा है उसके जगह पे व्हाट हैव आई रिटन, व्हाट हैव आई रिटन, कैन एनीबॉडी गेस? सो इन प्लेस ऑफ कमीशन द ओनली थिंग आई हैव डन इज आई हैव जस्ट रिटन आर अपॉन 100. टोटल सेल्स तो थी मेरे पास 5000, सो टोटल सेल्स इनटू आर अपॉन 100. तो 00 कैंसिल, 50 गोज दैट साइड, सो आर मिल गया मेरे को 6%. ओके, सो क्लियर हुआ यहां तक? नाउ आई विल सब्स्टिट्यूट दिस 6% इन एनी वन ऑफ दीज पार्ट. इन दोनों में से किसी एक पे मैं कमीशन निकालूंगी. So now what I do is I take the 6% and substitute in question in equation 1. Okay, so in equation 1 if I substitute, what will I get? Commission on 68,000. So rate of commission is 6%. Commission amount is equal to sales into R upon 100. Substitute the value of R in equation 1. So commission amount is 68,000 into 6 upon 100. So it gives me 4,080. So now I got the commission amount. Again, I will substitute further the values in equation 1. So 9880 was the income, is equal to salary was X, and commission kitna mil gaya? 4080. So 9880 minus 4080, so X aata hai 5800. So you got the salary as well. So what was the total salary? 5800. And what is the rate of commission? 6%. Okay, so we have finished sum number 1 se leke sum number 10, which was purely based on two formulas. One was commission and the other was income is equal to salary plus commission on sales. So students, thank you so much for listening. Tomorrow we'll be starting with a new concept of commission, that is discount. Till then, stay safe, keep practicing, keep learning. Thank you so much students. See you tomorrow.